Hi, my name's Laird Hunt, and I'm going to be reading from the start of Zori. She had never liked to dream. After diphtheria took first her mother and then her father, she was raised by an elderly aunt who told her that people were born dreaming of devils and dark roses and should beware. This aunt, whom her dying father had only called on reluctantly, for she had drunk too deeply from the cup of bitterness after a badly failed marriage, shook and scolded Zori vigorously when, as happened frequently during the first months, she woke up crying. If she woke up screaming, she received a slap. Sometimes she received a slap anyway, either because of what she was leaving behind in the dizzying hallways of her head, or what she was waking to. Zori came to harbor what proved a lifelong distrust of the deep hours, as her aunt referred to them, when the mind played tricks on itself. Days were different. Zori ran, she skipped. She won a prize at school for turning the best cartwheel. She and the other children played with hoops and balls in the yard. No one could climb a tree as quickly as she could, and there were only two boys in the school who could beat her at arm wrestling. The teacher, Mr. Thomas, would take them on long walks through the woods and across the fields. Often on these expeditions, they were asked to collect interesting objects. Zori would run back and forth like a dog working a field, her quick hands flashing down to the ground and up again. Heart pounding, she would bring her discoveries to Mr. Thomas for inspection. He would lift each leaf or mushroom or insect close to his face or up to the light or under his magnifying glass and, with Zori leaning over his shoulder or even holding the magnifying glass herself, murmur, "Yes, very interesting. This is a good specimen, Zori. Well done. Thank you."